I've teamed up with Elgato Gaming this holiday season to give away an HD60S. If you want to enter the giveaway, make sure to follow all the appropriate links down below in the description. I hope you guys have a great holiday, and I hope you enjoy this video. So if you're like me, you probably were left wondering yesterday, what the heck does Treyarch have planned for 2017? And if you guys have no idea what I'm talking about, let's do a small recap. So yesterday, Treyarch did a live stream, and this live stream only lasted about 10 minutes. And during the stream, they announced a couple different interesting things. The first thing being Newton's Cookbook. This is going to be a brand new feature making its way into Black Ops 3, and we'll talk about it in just a moment. The second thing that they said was that they are excited to show us what they've been working on for 2017. Now, I also think that this is in connection with Newton's Cookbook, but I also feel like this is something much bigger. And the only reason I say this is because this is the first time that we've ever had a studio like Treyarch do a stream like this in a year and in between years where they're really not the main focus of the main game. And I think that this could be taken directly because the sales of Infinite Warfare are down by so much. Maybe they need to come in and apply some pressure and save the ship from sinking, if that makes any sense. But let's talk about Newton's Cookbook first. What is this new feature and how is it going to affect you? Well, this is going to be a way to create your own gobblegum. And the reason we know this is because, unfortunately, the files have been found on the PC with a recent update, and there were a lot of images found and stuff like that. I can't show them on screen. I'll get a copyright strike or I'll get taken down because of it. But just know that it is a custom gobblegum creator. To what extent, I do not know. It would be awesome if we could take two gobblegums and combine them together, or if we can create our own whimsical gobblegums. I think it would be pretty cool, and it would definitely throw a new twist on the zombies experience. Now, if we take this a step further, what if there's like a secret gobblegum that you have to create in order to find the true ending to the final DLC map? Now I'm just throwing ideas out there for conspiracy theorists. I don't mean to do that, but it just sounds like something that Treyarch would do. But all in all, I think that this is a really cool feature, and I can't wait to see how they implement it in 2017. And speaking more about 2017, what do they mean by more content? Obviously, there's got to be more stuff ready for the multiplayer front. There are tons of people still playing Black Ops 3, and that's definitely noticeable considering they just added 3 new weapons as of yesterday. But for some reason, I have this little thought in the back of my brain telling me that they're not just going to sit there and keep adding this little content to the supply drops. I feel like there's actually something much bigger on the horizon that they had to bring together this whole live stream. And I'm not talking just about Newton's Cookbook, I'm talking about more for the multiplayer as well. And the DLC 5 concept, that's not seeming too far-fetched anymore. It seems like maybe they are going to pull something like that in order to bring some more sales in, because technically a DLC 5 wouldn't be part of the standard 4 maps, and it wouldn't be part of the actual season pass, meaning that everybody would have to pay $14.99 or whatever it is in order to get access to the maps. And I think that would be a good way to raise revenue, and it would also be an awesome way to get more people interacting on Black Ops 3. Now, what would this map entail? Obviously, the stuff that we're normally used to seeing. 4 multiplayer maps, possibly a new weapon or something, and maybe even a new zombies map. This would be something that I don't think anyone would be against, simply because I know a lot of people in the zombies community, including myself, feel like they've been left out in the cold when it comes to the ending for the final map. It just didn't really feel like the ending that we should have gotten, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was the end, supposedly, of the Treyarch Black Ops Zombies experience, and it didn't really feel like we had much closure. So bringing in a new DLC and possibly going that extra mile to close it out even better, I would definitely pay $15 for it to see what the hell happens. I think the obvious answer for multiplayer would just be more multiplayer maps and, of course, new weapons and things like that. But I also feel like they might go even further than that, if that makes any sense. Like, what if they actually add another character to the game, another specialist character? It's definitely possible. What if they expand on the characters and put more challenges in the game so we get more lines of dialogue and more recording so we can learn more about their backstories? These are all things that could quite possibly be added into Black Ops 3, and it really does have me excited thinking about it because it makes a lot of sense. If the sales are down for Infinite Warfare, they definitely need to make up for that lost revenue. And I think that adding a new DLC to Black Ops 3 would be their best bet, because Black Ops 3 was one of their best-selling games in recent years, which is crazy. So I think that there are definitely a lot of people still playing Black Ops 3, and that definitely shows with the new weapons they just added yesterday. But don't forget about Sledgehammer. They could still add some stuff to their game as well. Any type of revenue is going to be good revenue. Whether that is adding more stuff to supply drops or simply making brand new DLC maps, they need to try to find any way possible to bring in more revenue for their company. And I don't think that that's far-fetched to see a new DLC from Treyarch in 2017. They seemed pretty excited to say some more stuff on the stream, but unfortunately they weren't ready to talk about it. So that makes it seem like there is something major coming to the game, and knowing Treyarch, they're definitely in for the long haul. So let me know what you guys think down below in the comments section. The final thing that I want to say about this entire fiasco is I kind of feel bad for Infinity Ward, and I know that that sounds really weird to say, but they kind of get the short end of the stick, right? So think of it this way, they're the last to go within the 3-year cycle. You would think that they're one of the first, but they're actually the last to go now. We have Advanced Warfare that basically started this entire thing. People didn't like that movement system, so Treyarch actually changed it. They made it perfected, I like to say. And even though people didn't cling on to Treyarch's movement system that well, they kind of stuck with it and said, okay, this isn't that bad, this is okay. But people were bored of it. People were done with it. They didn't want it for a third year in a row. And by that time, Infinity Ward has already had 2+ years in development with this particular movement system. And it's not like they can just go back in one day and just cut it all out. It's kind of hard to do that. So that's kind of why I feel bad, because every single year they have a game come out, since Call of Duty Ghosts, by the way, it hasn't been sticking with the community very well because of the things that they've been doing in their games. But that's all I want to say for this video here today, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know what you think down below in the comments section. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to click the like button down below and subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. If you guys are subscribed to the channel, make sure to click the notification button so you are notified every single day that I upload. I'll see you guys here again tomorrow. Until next time, I'm out. Peace.